Hey, it's Huck. And I'm going to keep this real brief, because I could go on for a long time on this. And forgive me again for this. The good news is, I may not look it right now, but I'm actually feeling much better today. I actually was able to take this off for much of the day. I'm a little winded right now because I've been running around here setting this all up. So I decided to heck with it. I'm just going to go with it. I just wanted to touch on a couple of things that have been in the news, probably more than they really deserve, to be honest with you, this week. So they're not probably the biggest news of the week, but they certainly got the most attention. And it just, you know, I'm going to kind of group all three of them together because I see one common thread in all of this. So again, I'm just going to go right to it. You know, the powerful and I think courageous decision of Caitlyn Jenner to come out as she did with that cover of Vanity Fair and that photo shoot that she did. And then, of course, the other two incidents, completely different kind of thing. You know, the rather shocking news of Dennis Hastert, for 8 years, the House Speaker, longest serving Republican House Speaker in history, who apparently was allegedly involved with some sexual escapades with some minors that he was either coaching or teaching while he was a high school coach back in, before he served in the House back in prior to 1981. And then finally, the third item in the news, of course, is the whole stuff that has come out about the oldest son in the Duggar family, that Josh Duggar in the from the, I guess, the hit TLC show 19 and Counting. Now again, like Jenner, I've never watched the Kardashian show, and I've never watched this 19 and Counting, but I understand that, you know, both shows are rather popular with, you know, obviously different type audiences. So I guess what I have to say is, first of all, as far as Caitlyn Jenner is concerned, like I say, I think it was a courageous thing to do. I really do, especially someone that has struggled with this for as long as she apparently has. And I think she will be a big inspiration to probably millions of people around the world who are struggling with this and who are struggling, moreover, with families that are probably struggling with this. And I don't understand, frankly, one of the common threads in all of this is, and I don't want to rant about religion too much, but the truth is, you know, we sit here in this nation and we're outraged by what we see going on in Syria and Iraq right now with this ISIS group, you know, throwing gays off of buildings, for instance, and, you know, just some of the horrendous things they do for their religion. You talk to people on the religious right in this country and how they take these stands against gays and gay marriage, how they, the ones that I've talked to at least, have no tolerance at all or understanding any concept of transgender, which is separate than gay. And I ask myself, you know, are these people that ignorant of science? If you want to believe that God made everybody, okay, fine. You know, but God obviously makes mistakes. I mean, twins are co-joined. People are born with club feet and all kinds of, how many births are never even live births because, you know, some terrible travesty happens. So, I mean, there are people that are born hermaphrodite, you know, with genitalia from, you know, both sexes. I mean, there's all kinds of abnormalities. So the idea that somebody might be born with the emotional and thought processes of a female and yet with the genitalia of a boy, what's so difficult to get there? I understand that, just because you're 5-year-old wants to play with Barbie dolls doesn't necessarily mean that he's going to be transgender. I mean, it's much deeper than that. But as I understand it, the stories that I've read about or seen, you know, displayed on some of the documentaries that I've seen, you know, seem to suggest that this is something they say that is persistent, consistent, something that doesn't go away. You know, and at a certain point, I mean, I understand families would struggle to turn their little boy into a little girl, or their little girl into a little boy. Just the thought of that must be really deeply troubling to deal with. But it happens. In some cases, it does happen. And it's probably, undoubtedly, in some cases, the right thing to do. And why, how anybody, regardless of their religion, can feel that this is somehow immoral, I don't know what gives them the right, you know, to judge morality, to be honest with you. In this case, I mean, I don't know, I put them maybe one notch below the Taliban and ISIS. Yeah, they're not throwing, you know, gay people off of, you know, off of buildings. They're not stoning them to death. But, you know, they're shaming them. They're demeaning them. They're denying them their civil rights. You know, and it really, it bugs me to the point where I begin to ask myself, because, of course, they all flock to the Republican Party, these folks, all of them. And I look at what the Republican Party does. That brings me to Hastert. Hastert apparently was guilty of some abominable acts while he was a teacher and coach in a little town in Illinois long before he ever became, you know, a congressman. He managed to hide that and use his position as House Majority Leader, as House Speaker, I should say, to, you know, to promote and put on the agenda for a vote and to vote for and get passed things like don't ask, don't tell. Things like, you know, well, just all sorts of anti-gay and anti-gay marriage legislation. It brings me to the point where I have to ask myself, you know, how can anyone in good conscience, Christian or otherwise, be a Republican? It used to be there were Republicans I could respect. I really don't believe I can respect any Republican any longer. Certainly none that are elected to office that I know of. And frankly, knowing the individuals that are elected and what they're pushing for, you know, the fact that they are against voting rights for minorities, that they will stoop to just about anything to deny people the right to vote simply because they may vote against Republicans. The idea that they are against and will continue to be against, you know, extending health benefits to literally millions, tens of millions of Americans, simply because it was passed by a Democratic legislature and president. To me, these are unforgivable. These are unforgivable. You want to talk about morality? You know, I don't know where I stand on religion. I know I don't go to church. I know I was raised a Catholic, and I have so many issues with the Catholic Church over some of their public policy positions that I simply cannot attend that church. I mean, I have bigger questions on religion, but the truth is those people who speak the loudest, they're anti-abortion, anti-gay, anti-black, anti-minority positions, well, it's just, it's unforgivable. And it seems to me, to be a Christian or to be a Republican today, you have to be intolerant. And it, you know, I mean, Christianity to me means exactly the opposite. You know, when I think of Christianity, I think of Jesus Christ. And whether, if he is the person that's depicted in the Bible, as I understand him, you know, that is something I can get behind. I can get behind, you know, I don't know about the Son of God thing, but I can get behind the fact that he preached tolerance to one another. That he took people that the Bible, the Old Testament, said, you know, these were sinners, and he said, you know, you who are without sin, be the first to cast the stone. And he took these people upon him, and some of them became his closest followers. So, you know, to me, his whole thing was about feeding the poor, caring for the helpless, caring for the hopeless, and giving comfort to those who everybody else shunned. Tolerance. I don't know a single person who claims to be, you know, a fundamentalist Christian that displays any of that kind of tolerance. So I've got a beef with the Christian right. And I've got a beef with the Muslim fundamentalists as well. I mean, any religion that claims that, you know, homosexuality is a sin and that they should be denied civil rights. The thing about this country is that we're not based on religious law. I don't care what your beliefs are. You can't extend your beliefs onto everybody else. I have no problem if you want to attend your church and conduct, you know, affairs according to the beliefs of your church, as long as they don't affect me, my family, and other people in the community. You do what you want to do, as long as you're not forcing those views on everyone else around you. So, and I have a problem with the Republican Party, because they're as bad as the fundamentalist right in trying to force those issues, everything from contraception to abortion to, well, at any rate, so that's how I feel. I thank you for watching. I'm sorry this was brief, but I wanted to get something out on this, and I'll leave you with a little musical outro. Take care. I'll see you again real soon.